Good afternoon, everybody. His Excellency and Co-Chair, Mr. Daso Choang, Commissioner Election Commission of Bhutan. The co-presenters, His Excellency Ms. Chow Chee Lin, Commissioner CC of Taiwan. His Excellency Mr. Mohammed Irfan Rahman, Election Commissioner of Mauritius. Representatives of AWEB Secretariat, the Election Commission of Bangladesh, South Africa, Bhutan, Romania, Philippines, Sri Lanka, Cambodia, and others, Korea. Excellencies, heads and representatives of various EMBs, ambassadors and high commissioners and diplomats, representatives from AWEB, IFES, International IDA, and Malaysian Commonwealth Studies Center, Shri Umesh Sinha, Secretary General and Senior Advisor and Head, India AWEB Center, other colleagues from the Election Commission and all participants. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to again extend a very warm welcome to all of you in this second session of the international webinar, the second technical session. I join you all at this celebration of the second year of the AWEB chairmanship of the Election Commission of India and creation of the India AWEB Center. We have had a very fruitful first inaugural and then the first technical session, giving very insightful and thoughtful suggestions on the theme of the subject, which is the inclusion. Just to give you a little brief on what has been attempted here, the size and scale of elections in India is always daunting for anyone who hears this. With a large electorate of close to 912 million registered electors, and with a diverse ethnicities, cultures, social customs, beliefs, and terrains being as challenging as one of the highest peaks in North India to a very, very vast coastline in the South India, to having the wettest place of the world in the Eastern India, to vast deserts in the West, conducting elections have always been a very, very challenging task. And ECI, over the years, because of its robust procedures, has successfully achieved it. All these achievements and laurels are meaningless unless we ensure the elections in a very, very inclusive way and that every vote counts. We provide situations and the processes which are conducive for those for whom the accessibility matters. In words of Martin Luther King Jr., who once said, "If democracy is to have breadth of meaning, it is necessary to adjust inequalities." The very foundation of democracy lies in the representation of all stakeholders, and is indispensable part of this is the inclusion. The ECI has been working ensuring the inclusion from the very beginning, but during COVID and post-COVID, we have further experimented certain things which we'll share with you. So what I'll share is essentially about the women, persons with disabilities, senior citizens, transgenders, and how we make it inclusive and what's the level of task. That's what was mentioned in the first technical session also by the presenters. Women today have made their mark in every sector and all over the world, and including in India, from the sectors such as flying to information technology to financial sector, legal profession, effective advocacy across all sectors of public policy. And this is their contribution that needs not only recognition but respecting that contribution. In India, the participation of women in the first general election held in 51-52 was around 78 million, and that was 45%. It has now increased to 432 million, and that is 67% in the last elections. And we still strive to achieve higher. And in many states and many provinces, the women participation has exceeded the men's participation. Similarly, the contribution of PWD voters are invaluable in any society and therefore need to be fully respected. That they too have made their mark in every field, be it music or science or sports, and we at ECI believe in empowering them and more than that, learning from their experiences and from their motivation and determination. It was hard to believe for us that a few years ago, we did not have a list of as to how many PWD voters are listed. This was not marked. And in the last few years, we are now at 7.7 million PWD voters who are marked in our electoral rolls. And we achieve, and we target them, we reach them, and how, I'll explain. What has been done is that all the polling stations in the country have accessible features. There were many polling stations which were at the first floor. They have all across the country have been brought to the ground floor. They all have a ramp into, it is mandated by the commission that they will all have ramp and at an inclination which is around 1:10 or better for them. There are various kinds of apps, the braille on the ballot units, and there is a wheelchair available, and this is all mandatory. It's been mandated by, and therefore every polling station is supposed to have them. In this context, the senior citizens have been one of the most reliable voters, not just in India, but across the democracies. They have immensely contributed in the growth of their respective countries, and they have accumulated wisdom. In countries with aging population, senior citizens have raised the issues that concerns the society. We being the younger demography, they have ensured that they leave a democratic nation for the younger generation. That's the foundation they have laid. And we are fortunate to have blessings of around 15 million electors above 80 years of age. We have all listed them. And this time, we have extended the facilities for them to have a choice to vote from the comfort of their home. This is for the persons with disabilities and all senior citizens above 80 years of age. ECI is also committed to inclusion and increasing participation of all genders. Provisions for categorization as third gender on the voter identification card have been made, wherein anyone can indicate their sex as others if they do not want to be described as male or female. How do we translate these commitments to reality in action? One of the most far-sighted reforms that Commission undertook during the COVID-19 period and the elections last year which we held was to provide a facility of the postal ballot. And as I mentioned, that there are protocols, the polling agents, polling parties go to the house of the PWD voters or the senior citizens and they are allowed to cast their vote from the comfort of their home. We are serious about ensuring all such sections of society get to vote and no voter is left behind. Actually, their participation is more than voting. When a person with disability or a senior citizen comes to vote and everybody around sees the kind of respect which we are able to provide as a society, it goes much beyond voting. It's the ethos which gets created in the society, especially among youths, to respect the senior citizens and to respect the persons with disability. And that's what is our commitment. So it's not empowering them, it's only learning from them and taking advantage of their wisdom and differently abled competencies. Friends, in this respect, I am reminded of Mahatma Gandhi, father of our nation, who said, "Under democracy, even the weakest shall have the same opportunities as the strongest." We wish to walk the path of such foresight laid down by our forefathers and continue to enhance participation of all sections of society. Esteemed participants, we are looking forward to hear and learn from you all. I am confident the deliberations in this session will immensely add to the body of literature and help through sharing of innovative and best practices which are adopted by the various countries. Thank you very much.